Okay, so here we're going to show a demonstration of a custom media center. Diving right in, auto rip and compress is what we'll use to rip and compress DVDs and Blu-rays. As you can see, it's just like regular media center as far as the availability to grab Netflix, internet TV, your sports scores, music, pictures. But once we get inside Media Browser for television and movies, we'll see a world of difference. So here's the main screen, and we're looking at all the different folders. We're going to start here with television browser, since that's a little different from the rest. Basically, the way the system works is you have the TV shows that you like set up in here. As there's new seasons, you just add a folder for a new season, and it automatically populates it the rest of the way. So as every new episode comes out for The Big Bang Theory, it's automatically downloaded and put into this folder. The white ones are files that I haven't watched, blue ones are watch files, so that gives you a good idea of what you've seen and what you haven't. And when you have a large collection, that's very helpful. And that's the number one thing. Besides aesthetics, what's great about this custom home theater is a way to navigate an extremely large collection of movies and television shows and do it easily and quickly. Also, the benefit of being able to put it on a network and have multiple TVs use the same collection of media. Here in box sets, you see that under each box set, we're going to have a different number of movies. So there's different, obviously, formats and layouts to choose on how you lay out your box set folders. As we saw there, Back to the Future only had three movies. James Bond here has 24. So obviously, it's better for a film strip in James Bond and a nice big poster view in Back to the Future. So we go here to HD movies. What we'll see here is all my HD movies are 720p or 1080p. These are all Blu-ray rips. And if we go in, you can see the details it's given. You've got your next and previous button, which will take you to the next previous button in a movie in the folder, but also a description down here of the movie, IMDb, Internet Movie Database rating, whether it's 1080p, the format. And if we go here to actors, you can decide you might not want to watch this movie, but you do want a Sigourney Weaver movie. You click on the actor or actress that you want, and you're going to see all the movies in the collection that that actor or actress is in. So let's back out here. And also to navigate, once again, there's a lot of movies. These are just HDs, but you can use your QWERTY keyboard and just type in a letter or two letters to get to a specific movie. But now we're going to go on out and we're going to go to all movies. And what we're going to see here is that there's 961 movies in this collection. So there really has to be a very good way of navigating the collection. Once again, if you know what you want to see, it's easy enough to use your keyboard and type the letters to go straight to it, or just navigate down with your arrows on your remote. Here we are in American Beauty. Let's say we decide we don't want to watch that, but we do want a drama. Well, let's go back out, and there is a way to navigate for that. And basically, what we're going to do, if, sorry, guys. Basically, what we're going to do here is just go back out of this and up to the sort button, which right now says none because it's showing everything. We're going to filter it through genre. And you'll see here that it breaks up those 961 movies into 30 different genres. And so now we'll just hit drama, and we'll only see the drama movies in the collection, which there still are 357 of. But that does help narrow it down. And as you see here, there's American Beauty, and so on and so on. So as we click on a file to watch, there's going to be trailers that play from the new movie from the movies that are in the theater, and there's also going to be custom intros that I've designed. Now, the way I have this particular one set up is DVDs will play one trailer from new movies in the theater, then one custom intro. HD movies and new releases will play two trailers from the movies, new releases, and one custom intro. And animated movies will only play a custom intro. And that's because kids typically don't care about watching a trailer to see what else is out there right now. But that is all customizable. Once you get it, you can change the number of trailers, the number of custom intros. But let's take a look at a couple of the custom intros here. This is the spoof off of the 20th Century Fox intro. And I have this one playing before HD movies and new releases. This is one of the more advanced intros. It requires a 3D rendering program. And we do sell just the custom intro if you're interested in just that and not the entire Media Center computer. Looking at a few more here, these come before my DVDs, so non-HD, non-new release movies will either have this spoof play or one of two more that are going to be coming up here in just a second. Now also, these are for sale on our website, and the pricing is $25 to do a custom of the Paramount, Lionsgate, or Columbia intro, $99 to do the 20th Century Fox 3D intro, and also $25 for the Disney intros, which are going to be coming up here very soon. And the system also allows you to choose which intros to play before which section of movies. So you can have one intro played just before box sets, one intro played just before animations, and that's what this is. These two next two intros only play before animated movies. And this one's actually a spoof from the DreamWorks from Madagascar, with the penguins from Madagascar, who I think are pretty funny. So they're going to come out there and get their fish real quick. And we'll see one more custom intro for the animated movies. And then I'll show you the systems that we have for sale and where you can get them. This is going to be the last animated intro. It's a Disney spoof for Kennington Home Theaters. And this certainly is one of the better looking ones for animated films. And it's just nice. It brings everything together when you're watching, you know, at your house. It really does give it the theater experience, especially with the trailer intros. And it really is a show off to the friends too. So here we have the three computers that we have for sale. To the left is our base model, which is an aluminum case, quad core with 6 gigabytes of memory and 1.5 terabytes of storage. The middle is an aluminum case with an LCD display. It also has 12 gigs of memory and 3 terabytes of storage. The last is a Core i7 with 24 gigs, GTX 470 graphics card, and 3 terabytes of storage with a solid state drive to run the OS. So, three comprehensive packages ranging in price from $1,000 up to $2,700 depending on the upgrades. And there are upgrades available for all three systems at checkout. We use PayPal's secure checkout service. Thank you for visiting Steel Design Media, and please get in touch with us if you're interested in a custom home theater.